Today you're going to focus on patients and researchers, partners for life, as the conference material said to me when I was reading it over the weekend. But before I say a few words specifically about those issues, I'd like to say a further word about the standing that, in my view, EURORDIS has gained for itself as an organization and for the rare disease issues here in Brussels, because not all of you are here from Brussels. You're not all Brussels insiders. And I think it's fair to take that opportunity, therefore, to say that if I were looking in the health policy field for a model organization in terms of its management of funding strategy, its governance, its activism, vision, and creativity, this would be one of them. So I think that one of the reasons that rare diseases has over the last 10 years gained considerable profile in the European Union discourse is not just because you have a good case, but because that case is being admirably made day in, day out here in Brussels. And the message I would like to leave on the table for you is to make sure as you develop specific issues around rare diseases, as you are designed to do today, make sure that it's really linked up to the broader health agenda. And that's for two reasons. Firstly, because segmented messages don't carry much weight. It's always a little bit looking like special pleading. But the second reason is that the health policy agenda needs the vision and creativity and activism that can come out of a network such as yours. Over the next 5 years, it won't all be easy. The question, should there be any funding at all for the public health program? How big should the health window be in the 8th framework program? How big should the health window be in the structural funds? These are not questions for which the answer is evident. There is a huge downward pressure on public funding. There is a huge pressure to put aside everything that isn't economic because we're in the middle of an economic crisis. So I think we as believers owe it to ourselves to recognize that 95% of people out there, including some of them who take decisions, still haven't got the message. They haven't got the message that healthy life years for all citizens is crucial, that it's not just nice for the citizens who need help, it's crucial for our society and it's crucial for our economy. For more than the time I've been doing this job, under now 4 successive commissioners, we've plugged away at the message that health is wealth, as well as health is values. We've plugged away at the message that there must be zero stigma around suffering, especially when, as many of you will know and your patients will know, stigma comes not because people are necessarily fearful that they are going to be threatened by this or that condition, but because the explanation of the suffering that's out there is not yet known. And that's part of the definition of a rare disease. So I think there are huge issues around the positioning of health in our strategy for Europe. There are huge issues around the positioning of health in our allocation of public resources. There are issues around our valuation of health and our attitude to those suffering ill health. And on all of those issues, you have to make the connection. As our chairman has said in introducing today, the case can be made. Innovation for rare diseases has spin-offs for others. But that is a message that you have to put first in big, bold type every time you communicate about the results of a seminar like today. And I think that if you can continue in the future as in the past to make those linkages, then the detailed needs will be much more readily understood and taken on board. Because I'm neither a researcher nor a patient, in a way that's really the main message I wanted to bring today. I don't want to presume to say what we've done in the past is wonderful and to list all the programs and directives since 1999. I think, however, that the timing for a fresh look at the research agenda is very good. I think that building on Orphanet, building on the national planning process that's now underway, building on the baby steps we're beginning to take under the auspices of the Medicines Agency, we can do a lot more. But I think that showing that you have a clear vision what more is needed, and that you have a clear vision how that additional effort can bring benefits well beyond your immediate core constituency. Those are two things that it would be nice to see figuring in your conclusions at the end of the day. So I don't want to take more of your time, because I think having arrived early, the good thing is to get onto the substance also relatively early. But I am grateful to have had this opportunity. As I say, that it's a great day for me personally in terms of getting closer to some of the issues with the expansion of our responsibilities. But what shall we do with those responsibilities? You'll be able to put me in a better position to know by the closure of the proceedings, I hope, this afternoon. So I hope you'll enjoy the time in the room, and I look forward to getting the report. Thank you very much.